Welcome friends, it's Tech Tricks. Today we are going to discuss how to create an amazing layout. So I have opened Qgis already, and there are some layers shape files I already opened. So what you need to do is just open your shape files and what you want in layout, and go to the toolbar and click on new print compressor, right, and give it a name. Just 1 2 3 1 1 2 3, right? Okay, this is the file, you know, this is the layout. You can change page size or page orientation using this right side composition. So in here you can see it is now A4 type, right? Click on what you need. If you want better quality one for online users, so I recommend for A3 or A2, right? Go to the A3, otherwise it take too time to export. So this is the orientation, landscape, portrait. So in this case I'm going to give landscape, or number of pages there are 2. You can see it duplicated, right? Just like so. Page background, if you need landscape cloud, you can use any color shape field and give any color. If you want a back outline, it also possible. So outline width you can increase here. Now you can see. So in case, so this case I am going to give plain color white, okay, and we are going to import previous work face into this one, right? Click on the add new map and create a rectangle where you want this layer, right? So it is appear on the all over the rectangle I have created, and you can adjust it. You can adjust it, right? And using this move item content, you can move the layers in the face, right? And with the scrolling you can zoom in and zoom out. If you want a custom scale, just click on item properties and go to the scale. You can give any custom scale, right? If you want rotation, you can use here. If you want background color, just click on this and give a background color, right? Frame, if you need, you can increase the frame size. And grids also possible. Solid grid process. Yes, here you can use the previous map unit to millimeter centimeter default. So I'm giving map unit, and I'm going to add a title now. So click on this icon and like previous just drag, and here you can change the map. Here I'm going to give Linux map. It is good if you use capital letters, and it depends. So you can change font size, font type, bold, normal size, and from the font of properties. So I click on this one and you can get the font properties, and you can align it center, middle. Is it in it is adjacent throughout the rectangle you have created. And in this case you can also give frame background, and you can change position with here also. So font size and do 28 or 36, right? Linux map just, and in using add new scale bar you can just click on it. You can have a scale bar, and you can also change the font size, font color, position, right, using this frame option. You can also give background color, frame, and using add legend, you can add legend. Here you can see all the file I have, all the layers I have in face. Right now, now I want to change these files, and I want to remove someone, and I want to several columns. How do we do that? So go to item properties and tick off auto update. Right, if you tick on auto update, you can't change these. It will update it after you update it in the layer phase, previous working space. So hit on that, and you can click on 1 or 2 or 3, and from this one you can remove. Click on remove. So if you add, you can add the layers you have used in the face, right? So if you double click on that, you can change the name also. So I'm going to give rail. Okay, just like that you can change. Here the special case is you can change title font separately, bold 20. So you can see legend title font size has increased. Okay, item font, which mean these each one names, bold, you can see it has changed. So in this case I am not going to do bold. So columns, now we have only one column. You can increase the column size, columns. So I have now 6 columns, but it is not right, right? So I'm going to remove some layers. When you make in layout, don't remove, just adjust with the columns and name size, because I'm just do it for learning case. Otherwise keep the legend, keep the layers which are needed, right? Right here you can use rulers, right, like Photoshop, Illustrator, and here also you can use rulers. And with this score, you can scroll in out and zoom in, zoom out. So spacing, right? Go to the spacing and you can change the group spaces, which is mean which group, column spaces. So see the changes. The first group have title space have increased, right? So you can change it. Group spaces. So I can label spaces, right? It is changing. You can box spaces. I'm going to reduce it. Column space. Each column space. And you can see names and symbol are overlap, right? I'm going to you can see it's aligned with it. Using this spacing, you can adjust the legend and group and make it and fit it with the map layout. And north arrow here, click on arrow and from down to up create the arrow, right? You can increase the head size, arrow outline, line style, line width, okay, and put somewhere possible. So this is the basic layout and this is how we can create a layout, right? And you can, using this tool, you can add different styles, different symbols, and it is possible to add image also. Click on this one and you can add attribute table using this icon. Click here, right? This case very long attribute table and I'm going to delete it. So and after you finish here, you can export it, go to composer. If you want as a PDF, you can PDF. SVG also possible. Export as an image. Your name, W something. Save. You save.